So we have the two locks now. I just want to go through what I've found with the old lock. They are pretty much exactly match. They do everything that I anticipate. This one stands a little bit higher in the yoke. However, it doesn't affect anything else. So the old one, oh, the sun's coming out. The cable's okay. I'll try my best not to get too close. So, there's the cap. And there seems to be some kind of notchings on the inside. However, I don't think that looks like it should have something to do with something, but maybe not. Here's the cable. The cable can only go in that way. It can't go in any further. Well, we'll get to that. Inside there is this plastic and copper part, which is spring loaded, and on the other side one of them has a ball bearing which is spring loaded, and the other side has burnt or melted. It does look like it's melted, but there is no ball bearing. So on the inside, the only thing I can imagine that it works in is on this here. Down at the bottom there's a lug, and I'm wondering if the ball bearings pass over that lug. See if I can get it to turn. Actually, did it all move? It did, so it's not passing over this lug. It's not passing over that at all. So, could it be that it's upside down? It goes on that way. It goes on that way. It does go on, but look how proud it stands. But then when you put this on, which way is it? That way. Hold on, let's go to this part first. So that's where it wants to sit. See, it's sitting flush, and there are some little locators, but it doesn't keep it still. God damn it. Or maybe the locators are on here. So look how proud it stands. So it can't, there's no way that it can fit like that. Which means that this has to go this way. Which then in turn allows this to fit in. So what is happening, I can go to the on position and start the engine. I can go to the off position, nothing is happening. And I can go to the lock position. So on this one, let's see what this one looks like. So this looks reversed. Oh. Something just fell off. In the wrong place. Okay. Spring loaded. But it was on this way. So it's obviously different. So now we've got the copper rotating. Oh yeah, yeah. That stands right. Because it rotates on there. So, what's going on? So it's the same but different. It's the same but different. Could it be that this has been taken apart and put back together incorrectly? Could it be that the cable is supposed to be upside down? Well, the wires don't look like they've ever been creased. Because this is different, see where I'm coming from. But then, is that in the correct position? This can only go on one way. So let's call that 7 o'clock. Looks like 7 o'clock to me. Oh, would that work? Let me just put it back together. Going to happen? Will it go to the next position? Oh, it goes to the on position, off position, and the lock position. one position. That is allowed to work. But the ball bearing plates, the brass plates, do seem to be the same size. This is original. This is the new one, and you've just seen that it fits. I believe it can only go on this one one way. Was it that way? 7 o'clock, wasn't it? What do you think, guys? Could I use the new ball bearing? So my next theory is cable and dot positioning. Cables are in the same position now. Sorry, the locks are in the same position. Lock pointing up. Cable is to the left hand side on the new one, and the old one, cable, is facing the right hand side. So if we just have a look. In fact, can I even get that cable out? Let's pop that down. Are the dots actually the same? No, they're different, aren't they? I was thinking. No, I'm wrong. I was kind of thinking that maybe I could use that plate as well. But if I can get away with using the old cable, the old plate, but the new, just replace that. That is exactly the same size. Exactly the same size as that. I think it would work. Wonder what that's for. Why does it not have a bearing? It does sit flush. Wouldn't it be nice to use the new one? Oh, it comes out. Can we compare the wires now? So just sit it back in. That's where it goes. Yep, it can only go in one place. They are different. In fact, this one's even got a little fuse in it. I'm calling it different. See the new one for the Suzuki. Probably puts headlights on or something. Oh, what's that? Not noticed that before. Could that be the fuse? And yet there's still some missing. And here. Where's the red? Red goes to the opposite side, so let's say red, oh, there's a black that comes further down. No, I think they're different completely. But this. Almost an exact match. I've just noticed that the old one has a little notch there. What is that touching? In its position there. So down at the bottom we've got a brown with a white stripe. Is it possible to interchange this? Could I interchange this into here? Come out, you know you want to. It's got a little prying. Keep that safe. on the new one. Now bearing in mind that part doesn't have a ball bearing. So yes, it would fit. It would fit. Get the spring back. Put it back. The old one. Hold on. These are all facing inwards. Did I put that on incorrect earlier? Yep, this is definitely the old one. Okay, so it goes in that way. Turns. We'll go back to this one having three. Little dots.